We have Haydn Sonnad, the founder of Tesla. Haydn, thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Haydn Sonnad, and I'm the founder and chief evangelist at Tesla. We offer city-to-city ride-sharing that's safe, convenient, and delightful in Tesla Model Xs, you know, the ones with the falcon wing doors. Since April, we've more than quadrupled our revenue, hitting a $1.5 million annual run rate last month, and we're making more than double the revenue per car than anybody else, and with a profitable model. I came up with the idea 2 years ago when I turned 16, because I was obsessed with Teslas, but of course, I didn't have the money to pay for one. But after starting the service, I quickly realized how transformative ride-sharing was on electric connected vehicles. And it turns out that the operating cost of Teslas is 4 times cheaper per mile than on gas cars. So within a few months, my idea caught the attention of a team of startup veterans who have built and sold internet companies for hundreds of millions of dollars. And together, we've transformed this concept into an iconic consumer business. And the customer experience is great, with Wi-Fi and device charging and friendly pilots and healthy food and drinks and quality customer support, all running on an algorithmically optimized electric logistics platform. We just served our 10,000th customer and have had fanatic reception. We've maintained a 5-star rating on Yelp and 4.9 stars on Facebook. So what's next? More routes and lots of product enhancements. We've proven the model in Southern California with 20 daily round trips, and over the next few months are expanding into major markets like San Francisco, Texas, and Florida. We've demonstrated that on long-haul routes, you can deliver amazing, clean travel with a profitable model for a lower consumer cost, all thanks to the economics of electric. So I invite you to work with me to bring this to millions of travelers within the next year, so they don't have to wait to replace all those dirty fossil fuel miles with a travel experience that benefits our health, our communities, and our planet. Thank you, and have an electric day. I think the fact that we can offer a better service for a lower cost is truly revolutionary. And the fact that it's all based on this forward-thinking Tesla mobility platform is really, you know, economically really helpful to us. And also, it's just super cool to have electric cars and have so much environmental impact and take all these people out of dirty, you know, planes and buses and trains and put them into cars that are good for the environment.
Maybe talk us a little bit about the kind of like the customer profile today, and also how you ensure that, you know, the novelty of it being kind of electric cars is something that doesn't kind of fade away with time.
So when we initially launched, we thought the demographic would be like millennials that didn't have cars. But what we've realized is that everybody has a need to travel between cities at least some point in their life. And nobody's going to pay more for a service that's worse. And I don't really think there is that whole like big benefit of electric cars, because while that is super helpful for the consumer, they don't really care about sustainability. They care about a better product at a lower cost, and then one that's more flexible for them, one that's more convenient. So like, for example, on planes, the seats like on average cost maybe like $250,000 per seat. In Teslas, they're $25,000 per seat. And on planes, you're going between point A to point B with 100 people, so there's no flexibility. But with Tesla, we introduce points B through Z, so we can pick you up anywhere and drop you off way closer to where you actually want to be going.
Can you talk a little bit about the software layer underneath this and where you see a wedge from future entrants into this market if you're successful?
Yeah, so a lot of the IP right now is, you know, software. There's predictive energy modeling, so there's a lot of variables with Tesla supercharging, like the weather and, you know, there's someone next to you, so you can play all that, predict how long it's going to take. The more efficiently you can do that, the more time you can have the car running, so the more money you can make on that. There's vehicle valuation modeling. So for example, I just filed a patent that puts all the vehicle telemetry on an immutable database, like a blockchain, and then you kind of have like a really in-depth receipt of the vehicle's entire life, because you can query every bit of information like 4 times a second. There's kind of some sophisticated price modeling, like on airlines. But I think the big defensibility here comes with the brand, because, you know, like WeWork says, they've shown what brand value and what, you know, a community means. And I think with travel, it's the same thing. If you're spending multiple hours in the car, you want an experience that's very consistent. Like, how did Starbucks become a $70 billion company on a $4 cup of coffee? They created a great experience and one that's very consistent. And when you're dedicating 3 hours of your time to traveling, you want that to be consistent. You want to know that you're going to be able to get work done with Wi-Fi. You want to know that you can sleep. You don't want to know that you have to deal with other hassles and stuff.
But one of the things that I would think everyone would want is to get there quickly.
Yeah.
And in traffic, you run out of electricity, you've got to reboot. It takes time. It's not as quick as gassing up, right? So how are people dealing with I saw here in the notes that you said, well, people will take some time and get some air, go for a walk, relax. But I would think that most people just want to get there quickly.
So actually now, those notes may have been old, but we're basically focused on routes that are under 200 miles, and that's where the electric battery does not have to stop and charge. And we've seen that on, you know, right now we do between LA and Orange County to San Diego and Palm Springs, and it is a lot quicker to just get in a car and get your work done and drive, even if it's, you know, roughly the same time, then to go to the airport and deal with all the hassles of security and just lines and waiting on the tarmac. And it's a lot more consistent. Like, you know, Southwest flights, like mine recently got delayed 7 hours, and like that's, you know, what you expect with airlines. For us, if we're 20 minutes late, people get angry, but it's 20 minutes versus like multiple hours, and I think your travel times are more consistent on the ground.
You call the drivers pilots.
Yeah.
So you're looking for a lot from them, and they're part of the iconic nature of the business. What do you look for in pilots, and how do you scale them?
So what we really look for in pilots is that they're just great, awesome people that are willing to contribute to the community that we're creating. So a lot of them are like actors and they have side jobs. They're not full-time, dedicated, old chauffeur kind of people. They're engaging, interesting, young, you know, fun to be with people. But I think the bigger win here is once autonomy statistically is safer than human drivers, you can start replacing those people that are paid drivers with people that would be traveling on that route, but instead they book the driver's seat for free. So then you don't have to pay for drivers, and the car's doing all the work. They just have to sit there, you know, hand out coconut water and put the elderly lady's bags in the trunk.
So it sounds like, I mean, your roots are dependent upon charging stations and early sort of positions. Do you have any unique access into Tesla or conversations ongoing so that you can plan your business? Because, you know, the far enough ahead your visibility you have into where those are going to be, you can plan where you're going to add more fleets.
Yeah, so Tesla really understands what they're creating, and that's a big platform for mobility. And so they reached out to us, we've had discussions with them, and we're working with them to strategically deploy the superchargers in places that are most convenient for long distance trips, which isn't like what they've been doing right now, which is like shopping centers, where, you know, originally they thought they were building a platform for consumer and freight solutions, but now they're beginning to realize that it's really all about mobility.
All right, thank you, I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks to all of our finalists and to our awesome investors and for you guys just sticking with us. We're going to take a little break, huddle up, you know, figure out what we want to figure out, and come back and announce the big winners. Thank you.